Hello VSDC family! Today we are sharing free and pro methods to remove the green background from your video. This effect is great for cinematic scenes, virtual backgrounds for presentations, gaming overlays and more. Let's see how to do it in VSDC. First, add your video to the project and double-click it on the timeline. We need to crop it using the crop effect from Video Effects Transforms. Open its Properties window, find the crop mode and select Crop Borders. We'll crop the frame from the left, right and top to immediately remove unnecessary elements along the edges. This is especially important if there are unwanted objects in the frame that you want to eliminate without affecting the main content. Next, add the background remover effect, which can be found under Video Effects Transparency. In this effect, we're interested in two modes available under the Mode property: YUV Chroma Key Color for users of the free version and HSL Chroma Key Color for Pro version. Let's start with the YUV Chroma Key Color. Set the first two parameters to 0 and the third parameter to 3. Enable the Adaptive Alpha option and for the parameters below, set values close to the minimum. We use 10, 5 and 0 respectively. Next, choose the color to remove by using the Eyedropper tool. To refine the removal, click Add Additional Color and select the Eyedropper again. Then press OK. Continue adding colors until all the green disappears from the scene. There is no limit to the number of colors you can add. The more you select, the more accurately the algorithm will work and remove your background. After that, we need to adjust the options. Set the kernel size to 7x7 for smoothing out the edges. Increase the similarity value to refine the selection. A precision of 3 decimal places is usually enough, but you can adjust it even further if needed. Also, increase the values for min-max chromaticity V threshold to improve the keying accuracy. As a result, a slight halo around the subject may remain. Do not worry, we'll remove it using the color grading effect. Add a color grading to the timeline. Open the color grading panel, go to the LUT section and add a new LUT. Then navigate to color ranges and choose the eyedropper tool. Zoom in the scene to select the green color on the edges. This will determine which color the LUT will affect. Next, in the LUT window, completely remove the saturation of the selected green by dragging the endpoint and setting saturation to 0. Slightly adjust the surrounding control points to fully eliminate any remaining green from the scene. If just like in our example, some green color leaves, for instance, in the hair, it is also fixable. For that, you need to add another color grading effect and select the color of this hair. Go to the LUT and turn down the saturation of the green colors. Good job! Let's move on to using a different HSL algorithm. Temporarily disable the two color grading layers we created in the previous example. We'll turn them back on at the very end. Change the mode setting in the background remover effect to by HSL Chroma Key Color. Also, disable all post-filtering options. It's better to use them at the final adjustment stage. The next important step is to correctly select the green color using the eyedropper. You need to choose a green shade with medium brightness. Let's select the brightest green first. And you'll see that only the darkest shades remain visible on the scene. Now, if we pick the darkest green, the light areas become visible instead. In this mode, you can only select one color. The correct color to pick is somewhere between the bright and dark areas. Now we need to adjust the saturation delta. Then, to eliminate most of the remaining green on the background, increase the reduced contrast parameter. At this stage, we are removing all green from the background. Let's refine the edges by reducing the green tint around the contours using the hue delta and max hue delta parameters. Increasing these values trims the edges. Focus on clothing and hands rather than hair. Once you've reached the desired result, add the minimize filter with the minimum minimize level set to 1. This will slightly trim the edges. To soften the edges, add blur filter and set the level to 3. Watch the video and adjust all parameters if necessary. To completely remove the green outline, enable the color grading effects we disabled earlier. To refine the hair cutout even further, create a duplicate of the video and open the copy, which is usually placed above the original on the timeline. Reduce the crop effects frame so it only affects the head. Then adjust the background remover settings to improve hair extraction at the edges. Fine-tune all parameters as needed. If you switch to the scene 0, disable the visibility of the lower layer. The top layer will look semi-transparent, and its purpose is to enhance the hair cutout without affecting the face. Enable the visibility of the lower layer again. If needed, make additional adjustments in the background remover effects. That is all for today. Now you know how to use the background remover tool and how to fine-tune it using free or pro version. Subscribe to see what's next.